done some container activities. So let's check for Docker availability, and we'll check for the Docker images. Sudo Docker minus V. Sorry. Sudo Docker -V. So you have a running Docker. So let me check for the Docker images availability. Sudo Docker images. So you can see two images currently available. So now I will check for any container is running or not. So we have already two container available, but which is in existed mode. Let me try to run any of the container. So sudo docker start the container ID. So let me check again the status. So you can see the container is up now. So the docker start command will start the docker. Now I will stop again with the docker stop command. So let me stop. So I will use docker ps -a command. So you can see the docker is exited. Now I will get a so I'll again start this one. Now my container will be running. So it's up and running at 3 seconds. So now what I have to, I will check the top process starting on the container. So sudo docker top the container ID. So you can see the process one which currently running on the containers. So only one bin bash is running with a PID of 2582. No other further process are running. So next I will look the status of the particular docker. So sudo docker stats and the container ID. So if you look, you can see the stats, what is actually container ID, name and CPU usage, memory usage, and the limit, or how much percentage of memory is used. All those informations you can see here. So with the CPU, sorry, docker stats command, let me come out from here. So now my docker minus a. So you have a docker ps command, so which only list the running dockers. If you run this one, you can see only you have currently two dockers, but one is running, the another one is not running. So docker ps command will only list the running instance. Docker ps minus a list all the instance, all the docker container. So now I will pause the running docker. Sudo docker pause the running one. So now it should be paused. So let me check. So you can see the up in 2 minutes, but the process, when you pause, it will pause the processes. Now you can just check what is happening with the top command. Pardon, sorry, instead of this, let me copy the container ID in running. Only one process, but this will be in a pause mode. So now I will unpause the container. Once if you unpause, it start to run again. So I unpause with docker with the unpause command, docker container with unpause command. So now we will look for the container started. So it's up and running. So one more command is the, you can kill the process, or you could kill sudo docker kill so let me run, let me check. So you can see that the process is exited, means it stopped. So kill and stop are not similar, but kill will kill the process, all the process and exit. Stop just kind of shut down. So now I have gone with the certain commands, start, stop, kill, status and top commands. Now let me start the container again, and I will go inside the container. So let me start the container. You can check the status. So it's up and running. Now I will go inside the container. So how do I go? You can use attach command. Attach. So now you can see you were in another location, root some this container ID. So if you ls, you will be inside some other, so one of the particular container, inside the container. So you can come out from the container by pressing Ctrl P and Ctrl Q. So you can escape, come out without exit the container. So let me clear the screen and sudo docker ps minus a. So let me remove the container. Sudo docker rm the container ID. So I remove the container. Let me check. See, you can see only one container is up and running, the another one is removed. So these are the basic container activities for which you need to do. So I believe you remember, one is a listing container, ps minus a for list all the container, and ps is just to list running container. Next, docker start and stop, start container ID, it's already running. Then stop the container, then pause the particular container, unpause the particular container. Then you can check the top commands, top process running on the container with the top command, and you can check the status with stats command, docker stats command. Then you can kill all the process with docker kill command. Finally, you can remove the docker with the docker rm command. Thanks for watching. Subscribe my channel. We'll see you with another video.